asking what style you do. I said, I'm Pablo, and sometimes it's trap. Some people call it pop locking back in the days, but that term is worldwide, not so much acknowledged anymore. From the Netherlands, I know some people call it shocking. You know?
Wait.
So there's so many street terminologies. You know, different areas in America are inspired by each other, you know, in the street. Some people were famous and some people were less famous, and they were more going to the underground terms and became bigger and bigger. So there's so much information there, but it's very not grounded information. You know, like someone could say, yo, I know the guy who first did this. But that guy didn't see the whole world at the same time, you know. Could be that another guy 10 years before did the thing, same thing too, and they already called it something, but that term never got popularized. Some people call it boogaloo, some people call it strutting, and strutting uses a different way, different kind of vibration feeling, different smell, but there's also this vibration inside that kind of accents the beat. Mm-hmm. A different feel in the strutter. So, but I still, for me, there's still a deviation from the main style that this kind of robotic thing is, you know? Animated robotic kind of illusionary dance stuff is. For me, everything comes down to that illusionary thing. The different terminology is confusing, but if you find out more and more ways, and you understand, okay, that's it. You know, that's a certain take on the style, and that's a certain take on the style, and that's another take on the style, and this is this feeling, and this is this feeling, and this feeling, this uses these muscles, and this uses these movements, and this, you know, then you can start to get a better, broader perspective on the whole. My take is this, like, there's a lot of richness in those different terms, so get to know them as much as you can. And I go to certain people, and also they really contradict a lot. You know, some say this is this, some say it's exactly the same thing as another way. And there's a lot of confusion. But take both and just think which one makes more sense for you. There's a certain way to get to this. Very revolves around catching the most obvious and most apparent things in music. Just to please the crowd. You know, the crowd really reacts more to clear
obvious.
Obviously, wow, okay. Eventually, everything is about a certain way of structuring and systemizing the body to use with the music. Right? And certain music has different feeling at certain areas and certain moments in time, and that creates a certain behavior that comes with dance, you know? And that gives a certain characteristic to dance. Personally, I think any style on high level is equally hard. That's my personal opinion. You know, any style, if you're waving and you want to make the best label, just as difficult to be the best walker. So, but I understand her thought of it because animation is most very free in form and in body movement. Actual movement is really free. Like, you know, you can do anything, right? And in that sense, it has less boundaries. And something with less restriction, less boundaries, there's more freedom, and the more freedom, the more possibilities. Yes, a lot of therapy for the ethereals. And there's very much qualities inside that can be used to texturize the movement. And the texture gives a tear maker a lot of possibilities to emphasize the meaning in their storytelling. That's why it's so hard. Because all this stuff, like you can add the tensions and speed, you know, playbacks and all that. You can see, you know, those stuff. Those give you a lot of rich materials, that, you know? It has, the right way has gives more meaning to any movement that you make.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So, movement at its base can be very meaningless, or sometimes it has a very, very clear meaning. But if you add and change the rhythm and the section and division that affects and put all that on top, you can give it so many more layers of information at the same time. Using the same thing.
Yeah.
And I'll add different layers and perspectives to it. And so for me, dubstep dancing is just very new era way, you know, again, I can use means like most dancing moves, like most effects. This whole dance was created by young people, like kids, you know, a lot of kids in that era looking for this dance. And dubstep is basically, again, the kids nowadays listen to this music and they change and they use it and they make it as their dance, right? So it has meaning, you know, because
Okay.
As soon as you hear that term, buy it, invest it.
Yeah.
I would take that time. Yeah, just go with, you know, go for it.